Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready with the game. It's going to be a fantastic one. HellRaisers versus Titan, best of one, SLTV Starseries Season 10. So welcome to Room on Fire. I'm Anders, with me is Semler and Vendetta, and we are just about ready. How do you guys feel about this matchup? It's going to be on Inferno.
It's going to be a pretty sick match.
Yes!
That's the easy way to go about it. I think it's going to be a great match. So
this is pretty straightforward, lads. Hold on to your pants, or your hats. Whichever. But HellRaisers versus Titan, this is excellent. We haven't seen Titan play in days! Days!
Oh, just take off your pants and let's have a party that, you know, really will be remembered. Because this is going to be a pretty sick game. And actually,
the
I think...
webcam is off, Anders. How do you know if they're on or not?
Oh,
pants aren't actually on right now. Just saying.
I'm wearing shorts. It's hot in Denmark. But
it's hot in Sweden.
They can come off pretty quickly. You know, that's the... that's the good news.
Smart swift maneuver.
Oh, I know.
Exactly. I have a lot of practice. Look, what I really worry about is, we've seen HellRaisers play in tremendously well in the last couple of days, so I'm not at all worried for them. Titan, I know they've been practicing a lot, and they have a lot of reason to be, you know, practicing hard these days. Can they catch up to HellRaisers? That's what I'm wondering. I mean, if this is the Titan of, you know, at their hype, you know, when they were the best, yeah, they can definitely beat HellRaisers. But if it's Titan, you know, post or, you know, before DreamHack Summer, I'm not so sure.
I think a lot of it comes down to what Titan shows up. I think you're absolutely right. What we've seen from Titan as of late has been fairly underwhelming for a team of this caliber. And in many ways, they're going through the same kind of journey as HellRaisers did in many ways. Because if you look at on paper, Titan is a monster team. It's a beastly lineup, right?
Yes.
But they're not really making it work as a team. And that's what HellRaisers went through a couple of months back. So hopefully they've gotten over the slump and NBK.
We're about to find out because the game is live, boys.
Right, what has NBK bought? Play, guys? Oh, wait, what? Oh, yeah, he's been doing this. The dualies. He's been doing this. This isn't something that just like catches everybody off guard. NBK, past few games, he's been going for the dualies. He's got no fear.
I really don't like the dualies.
All right, we have to watch. Dude, I'm just going to say this. We just have to watch Kenny S. Because the last time we saw Titan play Inferno, or at least the last time I saw him play, was on was at DreamHack Summer versus NIP. And Kenny S played out of his freaking mind.
Yes,
so
he did.
We need the same kind of performance here because, you know, we got to break some things.
Yeah, it's on you, Kenny, to step it up. And he's in the middle of the USPS, so a pretty good position for him to get some headshots. He's going to pull out the grenade for a little bit. Actually, he's going to smoke off towards the guys of the B-bombs, and that might be the wrong timing. Existence, though, with the first kill. MBK's up here on the balcony, getting shut down a little bit. He's going to have to retreat, and Kenny's going to be there just in time. But he misses the shot, and Markolov comes up from behind, takes one, takes two, and now the A-bomb side is lost. MBK's still here, just keeping an eye on things, but he can't really do much to prevent the bomb plant. In fact, he's going to go down.
The timing from Markolov was brilliant. He just completely caught Titan unawares. And a great shot from Angel to pick Smith off a short. This is falling apart. What looked like a decent situation for Titan has completely crumbled. Now it's all down to Scream. 1v4. Granted, three of the members for HellRaisers are very low on HP, and he's just thrown a perfect smoke to cut two of them off. But this is not looking good here for Scream.
No, it's not. And now that they spotted him, they actually just shoot through the smoke. They don't even care, and he will go down. So, I think you're right, though. I mean, wouldn't you say, Van, that was pretty much it. Markolov's timing there broke that bomb site very quickly.
Yeah, it definitely did. But it felt like Titan were in a pretty good position, seeing how Existence got that interfrag onto Kuchu and Naps. And again, I'm not going to put it all down to the pistol choice of MBK, but I definitely think he should have picked up at least one guy in quad, and that might have delayed the rotation for Guineas, because as soon as MBK has to back off and Existence dies, then or Existence is forced to hold quad alone, then, you know, that kind of forces Guineas' hand, and that allows for Markolov to backstab them, pretty much.
Oh, Markolov, it's so close to being the wall bang, but he's hesitating a little bit. MBK's up there. I kind of want to see him shoot through, because you could see MBK was just watching the bullets on the wall then. We'll see if Titan have more luck. I mean, this round they have body armor on two and then a lot of grenades here. In spite of having only pistols, they've bought up grenades like it was a normal round almost.
So that's a lot of grenades. Yeah, I'm curious to see what they're going to do with the smokes.
Well, right now they're putting them down, trying to stop this rush coming in from quad, but I'm not sure that's going to work. Actually, HellRaisers run all the way in, and then they run back. I'm not sure that was because of the smokes. I think that was just because this is what HellRaisers wanted to do all along, is just show their presence, force the rotation. You can see Smith rotating his library, and then leaving Scream alone, and with the CSAT 75, even if he gets a double kill, it's not going to be enough for them to win the round, and he does pick up a double, then tries for the AK, has it in hand. Oh, God, Scream, so close to actually winning the round right there. It's back to a 3-on-3, but the bomb is going to go down here, and that's why I said I don't think they can win it from this 3-on-3.
This is a tough situation, and okay. Existence actually picks off a Dren. That was some accurate sniping from the French in-game leader, and now it's all in Doja.
Yeah, and they triple-team him, and he almost gets all three. I mean, Smith has 14 HP, but that's enough time. What a sick round here at the second round already from Titan. And Scream apparently did enough, so I was wrong. Well played on Titan's part.
Yeah, I think actually some of that is more on HellRaisers fumbling this. Adren definitely should have killed Existence quite a few times there before he went down to him, so... And I think if he does that, then all of a sudden we're talking about a 2v2 situation with HellRaisers in superior positions and weapons. But it didn't quite work out for them. But they're buying up with CSET 75, so...
And even more than that.
Yeah, an additional smoke. Yeah. But yeah, this could definitely... it's definitely doable for HellRaisers to win this eco.
Let's see, I'm wondering, they've got three people over here and none of them are going to flash out. I sort of want someone to flash so Scream can take a peek, but they're just waiting on this corner anyway. Doja does pick up the first kill and they're going to double team Scream. He does fall back just in time and then the smoke is up. Kenny in the back of the bomb site here does damage and takes down Kucha, who apparently, yeah, they definitely thought, you saw that, HellRaisers, they thought there was only going to be two people here. Now they realize, one.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised they didn't notice that because that smoke came from sight.
Yeah. It's true. Markolov with another good pickoff. This is looking this is a really solid eco round from HellRaisers already. They don't get the bomb down, but those two kills on Titan are, you know, they're going to make a big difference later on. But you're right, that smoke did come from the bomb side, and they still didn't realize Kenny was going to be there. Because you could see Kucha just going for the straight plant.
Exactly. And I'm not really sure if that was something pre-planned from HellRaisers, and they just felt like they needed to get the bomb down instantly if they wanted to have a shot at it, but that could have ended very... badly for Titan if HellRaisers were a tad bit more observant. Because I think if they only devote two people to that B bomb site, they could probably catch a lot of people off guard on A, or the two people left on A.
Look at this position. This is definitely brand new from Titan. We have not seen them hold like this. I can't remember anyway seeing them do like. I mean, we've seen them have three people on the bomb site, but not in that kind of constellation. So I'm really curious to see what the point of that is. Obviously, yeah. If it's going to be a B rush, it's pretty effective, but...
Yeah, we've seen some people do this, like stacking up towards the B bomb site early on, but normally that's to gain control over Banana, which is something Titan did not opt to do. Luckily for them, though, there was no quick play coming up from HellRaisers, so the fact that Arch was completely open and... well, completely naked, nobody was really watching there at all, that didn't bite them in the butt.
Well, this time they've done some good damage to MBK, just being shot at down from Boiler Room, but we'll see if that's going to actually help them once they decide to move. And look at the clock. I mean, there's not a lot of time left here. 35 seconds, and they're going to go for the B bomb site. Scream has another smoke up, which means now HellRaisers, they have to commit through the smoke, which is not easy. They need excellent flashbangs. Markolov is over here trying to see if he can draw anyone away, and MBK is still fighting, taking even more damage, but it's going to be the speed bomb site. That's the only thing that matters right now. Scream and Smithson, they have the rifles for it. They're going to fall back. 15 seconds on the clock, and they actually move away. away from the smoke just as it disappears. And now HellRaisers is going to go 10 seconds left. This is complete madness from the CIS team. 6 seconds. They're going to have to plant right now. Smith is just going to go and kill Kutra. And the round is won with that one click of the mouse button. No chance for HellRaisers to do anything. Vendetta, what on earth was that?
This is typical HellRaisers play. Normally, they're a team who likes to use the clock for what it's worth. That's nothing new with HellRaisers. It's actually one of the things that I hated about the team prior, because they lose so many rounds they should be able to win by just not going in. And right there, we saw them working so hard and actually getting a pick on A to force a rotation for B. And when that never happened, they didn't really do anything with the three guys they had posted up towards B.
No.
And that kind of led everything, that led to the clock running down. And that's not something you can do. Obviously, you want to force the rotation, but you kind of have to, swallow that.
You need to have a plan B, that's what you're saying. You can't just swallow your pride at
a certain point and say, well, we're not going to find the entry frag, so let's just go with what you planned and hope for the best. But yeah, they didn't, and that kind of bit them in the ass. And as you said, the second he takes out the bomb planner coming in from Banana that round, it's over.
All right, Kenny's going to take down Angel, so it's a pretty good early kill here. Doja coming around the C-set, 75, and they're actually going to jump down from Balcony and take down Kenny eventually, and it's somehow back into a 2-on-2. Those kills happen so fast, I don't actually know what the hell just happened. Markolov is inside, and Existence is in a pretty good position, and all he has to do is wait, and he's clever. He is waiting for Scream to come and help him out, but Scream's got to pull out his gun instead. He's running with his back turned. Adrian is inside the bombsite here, and it's a 1-on-2 for the terrorist player, and he is going to take down Existence, turns around, and then Scream is there for the headshot. So a very close round, and HellRaisers, they were only partially bought up in this round, so they almost bring it home, but I have no idea how that happened all of it.
I really like to see how patiently Titan played that last one. And a lot of this does seem to come down to Titan just really playing a very patient, controlled game. The kind of game that we expect to see out of them, really. Measured, they really take their time, they play the smokes, they play the nades, just like in the round before this one, but in that one too, they played the fact that they had two guys. One of them dies, that's fine, because it sets it up for the other one to get the kill. That's just Titan really locking it down and making it very difficult for HellRaisers. And we have to remember, in the past, when HellRaisers beat Titan, it was because HellRaisers were able to come out despite those sorts of situations where Titan were playing to their advantage. HellRaisers were still able to manage to pull off crazy frags and get out ahead of it. So HellRaisers need to be the ones here to break Titan, basically. They need to come up with those sick 1v2s and just sick frags to turn the tide. Otherwise, Titan are just going to keep manhandling them.
Yeah, and as much hate as Existence gets from a lot of, or on a lot of the community forums, you couldn't really ask for a better player to have in that kind of situation. Like, sure, he might not have the best aim, but he's definitely one of the smartest CS players out there.
Yeah.
So if you want a guy in a pressure situation like that, then he's your guy. And he played that perfectly. As Summer said, sure, he dies at the end, but that just gave Scream the time to actually get up close and personal with the last HellRaisers member.
And now it's going to be an NIP type execute towards the B bombsite. One guy towards A and the rest trying to get in on B. But again, HellRaisers basically deciding to run through smoke, and it just doesn't work as well as it could. Luckily for them, Doja got a pick off over at the A bomb site, which means now they're rotating back. But again, with 30 seconds left, it's not a lot of time to get into a bomb site. If they screw anything up here, it's going to go horribly wrong, and NBK already putting a stop to it. And Kenny is going to go down. That leaves NBK alone up in the apartments. The bomb will be planted once again, but it's a 2-on-3 here, and Doja and Kucha, they have a lot of work ahead of them.
They're in a great position, though, and they do manage to set it off. I mean, they start off strong. They're managing to pull Scream out from library, do a lot of damage to him, and Kutra on the A site gets NBK, who takes a peek as well. It's all down to Doja now, who's in the pit. He takes the fight at range and finds Scream in the end, and now it is down to Smith, who's just going to get caught out in the open here.
Yeah, all they have to do is wait. They don't have to challenge him, but they will. And Doja, the hero from last game when HellRaisers played, now with triple kill and putting himself actually as a top fragger, 8-2-4. And here's where it gets really interesting, because Titan, in spite of having won 4 rounds in a row, it's been so close that they actually can't afford to buy. Even losing 1 round is enough to send them back to an eco. NBK will pick up a Mag 7 and body armor, which is kind of interesting, but that's more just evening out the money at this point.
Yeah, I think it's more down to that. And the reason why Titan end up in this situation is because HellRaisers, that round, they let the time run out on them. They managed to hold on to 2 weapons. And with those 2 weapons, they almost created havoc with the Titan team the following round. So what would normally be I guess, an eco for HellRaisers, and around where Titan can start bolstering their economy, they had no real opportunity to do so.
Oh, Smiths. Did he have auto-pick weapon up then, or auto-switch? Yeah, because he got the one kill, and I think actually he would have, any reasonable human being would have just kept on shooting with the pistol instead of trying to pick up the AK, or if he wanted to shoot with the AK, he would have just picked it up and fallen back till he can actually get it all the way out. So that was a little bit unfortunate, but still a pretty good idea coming out from Smiths and Scream, and they got the one kill in, they didn't really have much, so I'm not too displeased.
I think it really cost him there. I mean, do you think that was intentional, or you know, that can't have been intentional, because I think that cost him. I think he could have very well gotten a second kill there with the P250.
It
he was already lined
fast.
Up and spraying.
Yeah, it looked way too fast to not be auto pickup. Yeah, which is weird because most people, or I think it's almost safe to say that pretty much every pro plays without auto pickup on.
It is literally the worst thing in the whole world.
Yeah, it really is. It really is.
You only have to have tried it once that you know, you're in a battle with someone and you happen to run over a weapon and pick it up and it's empty, and then you will never have that command on ever again in your whole life. So,
yeah, I think it's actually the only people it's beneficial to is completely new players who don't realize that they've picked up a weapon.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
That's pretty much the usage. That's how far the usage of that command goes.
I don't know. I'm convinced that...
It looks like auto pickup.
It did. But like that command got faded out with the M4A1, because never in all of your life do you ever pick up an M4A1 that has any bullets in it.
It's true. If it's on the ground, it's probably because the guy who had it died because he ran out of bullets, so you
exactly.
Pick it up. You're just going to be next. But look at this round, though. Smith's already down to 13, and there's another shotgun on MBK. Smith goes down over at that bomb site, and again, Titan are holding three people over here, which might work out for them really well right now. They need those three people, and it's Kenny! Sorry, they don't need three people. They just need Kenny to pick up that triple kill. Markolov and Adrian are left, but that was obviously a pretty huge triple.
Holy hell, that spray. That was the thing of beauty. And now we really have to see Titan shut it down here on the A side. They can't let that good work go to waste. They've just been gifted this round. NBK with the Nova goes hunting, picks Adrian out of the sky, and now it is just going to be Markolov. Alone, 1v4 with the bomb. He's looking towards A site. He's about to run into Existence, and Existence, he spotted him. So now, where does he go?
Markolov, best case right now is for him to pick up some really good kills. If he can get two more kills here, that'd be huge for HellRaisers, but he's not going to do it. Existence will take him down, and that's a very good round for Titan. They only lose one person, and that's all. So their economy can start to look a little bit better. Unfortunately, HellRaisers can still buy, but this is still... I mean, this is going to be a close game at this rate. 5-3 is the scoreline.
I'm actually surprised to see Smith's picking up a FAMAS instead of actually getting a drop from one of his teammates. Both MBK and Kenny S could have potentially dropped for him, but guess they opt to save some money instead.
Oh, flash into the middle, and Existence taking a really quick peek, but I'm not going to do anything with it. MBK takes the return as Angel tries to come around the corner in the middle and get the return frag. So pretty good teamwork coming out here by the A bombsite. And what I'm really worried about is if HellRaisers realize there's only two people holding in the beginning, a rush to this bomb site could be quite devastating, I think.
Oh yeah, that's definitely possible. And I'm not really sure if I'm loving the rotation for Titan. Okay, Kenny has this, fortunately for the Frenchman, rotating back towards Arch. This could get scary still, though.
Yeah, there's still three guys holding solid here. It comes down to whether Kenny... Okay, he spots the nades coming out now. There's one nade actually towards Arch, does a little bit of damage to Kuchar. And he's already looking for the wraparound through CT spawn. Now does Kenny actually turn around at the right time to get this? Existence with a great headshot on Adrian in A apartments. That's going to shut him down, but Markolov finds Kenny S in the meantime, and now it's a 2-on-3 situation on this A site.
Yeah, they're sandwiched in, and look at the rest of Titan over at the B-bomb site. They're not quite sure this is even happening. NBK with another great kill. Fantastic defensive player, especially in this A pit. He's so good at it, and it's going to be just Kuchar left here fighting it out. NBK picks up a double. Existence does go down, and HellRaisers, if they can get this bomb plant. Actually, Kuchar's trying to go for the jackpot here. He wants the kill, and then he's going to go for the plant.
Kuchar, he's got 10 seconds left as well. The bomb will get planted. Now, there aren't that many nades left. Smith does have a molly. But Kuchar, no nades to work with here and only 16 HP. Scream is going to be the first one on the site, but there's the molly going down. Not necessary, though. Scream catches him out in the open, and this is going to be Titan's round, although they took quite a bit of damage. Seems to me like they could have done that a whole lot cleaner there, Titan.
I actually think Titan got a tiny bit lucky as well. Because the second Markov picks up Kenny S in library, that means they have a chokehold on the two remaining Titan members on that A-bomb site. And they could have more or less squeezed Titan into a really awkward situation, but it took Markov a tiny bit too much time to actually get onto the site, and in the meantime, MBK was able to pick up a frag on the one guy in quad. And I think that much pretty much sealed the round for Titan at that point.
Now Titan are going hyper-aggressive, and Scream gets a friendly frag coming in there, so not a good idea. Now it's down to a 2-on-3, still in favor of Titan, because this aggressive push did work, but look at Adrian. He's walking up behind. He must be able to hear MBK. He's going to peek out with the AK, but he does not get the frag, surprisingly, in fact. And it is a 1-on-3. But that last round, I think there's actually something else that's really worth talking about. I think the last two members over at the B-bomb site for Titan, you saw how they were affected, I think, psychologically by what HellRaisers have been doing earlier. Because they'd been pushing so late, the people in B didn't actually want to rotate out because they weren't sure if it was going to be a B push, even if there was only 20 seconds left. So that's worth noticing as well.
Okay, now was it HellRaisers LDLC just last night that we were watching on Inferno?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
I believe
right.
So, right? And what did we notice that HellRaisers were doing a lot of in that match?
Well, they were picking a fair bit. But
they were
again,
going for B.
Yeah,
they were going for B. A lot. It seemed like every round HellRaisers were going for B. Now, watching Titan throughout the beginning of this half, they constantly are not willing to rotate off of B, and they put an extra man on B early on. I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, but this feels like Titan have watched a demo, and they're like, well, it seems like HellRaisers are really, favoring B these days, guys. Maybe we should put a little emphasis there.
I think one big difference, though, from how Titan are playing it and how LDLC played it is the fact that LDLC were constantly showing their face.
That's true.
That gave openings for players like Doja to get that early frag onto B, which obviously makes you want to put more pressure towards that bomb site. Titan are not really giving them that option, but it's understandable that they want to be deliberately late with their rotations over towards B, especially in that previous round we saw. Then Markov ran in towards spawn. Kenny S didn't really have any idea what was going on.
Oh no, the charge to the B-bomb site. This is the one round where Titan only have two people here. Smith has been dinked as well. He's down to 16, and he might be going down if they can just come and find him quick enough, and they will. So bomb is definitely going to go down if Angel can just actually jump up here and put it down, but he's failing to jump a couple of times. 2-on-3. This would be a painful round for Titan to lose. They are just starting to build their economy. They got to win it. The bomb is down. They can retake this. They still have the advantage, but Markov's already got a double, and that's scary.
That's a very tough spot. Now Markov looking towards CT. Fresh smoke cutting off CT as well. That's going to start hemming in the players for Titan. And it looks like MBK's just barely found a crack to work through. And he gets a great kill on Markov at the back of Dark. Now it's Doja in yellow. He's looking, expecting MBK to come through flowers. And that's the right guess.
Oh.
It's not even MBK. It's Existence. And he gets the headshot.
Oh my god, Doja. How did he get that flick? And even worse, how did Markov not just kill MBK? He had a long time to shoot. I mean, the smoke still work, so that the guy outside the smoke has a massive advantage. So I actually think maybe Titan could have lost that round even earlier in that 2-on-2, but still very very cool job from HellRaisers rushing that bomb site, getting it done, and forcing Titan to eco again. This is the problem. I mean, we had four rounds in a row initially from Titan, then we had another three just now in a row, and in spite of all these rounds strung together, they just can't buy. That's what it's down to.
It really is, and you can see that Titan are going back to putting three people towards a B now. Even though it's an eco there, we're not losing a round to that stuff again.
This time HellRaisers is having a little bit more luck against the CSET 75s. Of course, until I say that, I curse Dozier and he dies to screams. In the pit, Existence is here with a hand cannon. A four-hand cannon's trying to see if he can get a 1 Deegan on somebody. And he does some good body damage, but it's not going to be enough. And the last flick shot is just a little bit too much wishful thinking there. Scream is going to be alone. And the best case for him, definitely try and save this M4A1. We are in the 12th round. Then it's going to be 7-5, which is actually a little bit scary. If HellRaisers win one more round, this could be 7-7, basically.
Yeah, I think the thing that calms Titan down is the fact that they will be able to buy up the next round, even if Scream goes down, yeah, which he does. But they're going to be able to put up a buy here, and I think if they get to 8 rounds, they'll be okay with how the first half turned out. Especially because they lost the pistol round. Sure, they won the eco round following, but they lost the pistol, so getting 8 rounds is probably okay for them.
Do you think 8-7 is enough, really? Going out of this?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I'm thinking like Titan. If they don't get 9-6, they're going to be hard pressed. I think HellRaisers is definitely going to speed it up because HellRaisers on the CT side are very, very good.
Yeah, I think a lot of it comes down to the pistol round, as it oftentimes does.
Yeah,
with teams of this caliber, it's the small things that really really put you over the top.
Oh, they do get the opening, but they lose Angel in the meantime. Good grenade going to rain out right in the face of Kutra, and actually only does a little bit of damage. I'm not sure why. Adrian going to run in, and NBK takes him down, so great defense coming out once again. Titan back on top here. Markolov taking the battle and will not win it. NBK, I mean, he's really been the champion of this A bomb side initially. Well, he's got 12 kills more than anyone else on his team. Dosha, best case scenario, try and get some more kills here. Maybe take down Smiths. He's not got the bomb, actually. That was dropped all the way over at A, so never mind.
Yeah, he gets caught off guard. I think Smiths is kind of wondering, like, why is he pushing Banana when the bomb is all the way over by A? NBK in apartment, good spray control, finds Dosha in the end. It's funny to think that, you know, it's like NBK who's top ragging right now, but A site has definitely been seeing the majority of the action here. Existence is close behind him with 11 frags. So you can really see who's been getting hit hardest on Titan side.
Yeah, no doubt about that. And this time, NBK actually does go for a really quick smoke down towards the bottom of Banana, just trying to see if they can keep HellRaisers back. And yeah, Titan, are they going to push behind this? I kind of want them to because they've been holding so passively. Aggressive hold might work out, but Adrian, he does not care. Going to take down Scream, and that's obviously a great kill to start off with. Now HellRaisers just need to work this advantage so that they can come up with another round here. Oh, MBK, timing is everything. He's going to flash out, but they're right around the corner and they'll take him down. He couldn't get the right timing. Now Existence is completely alone. Backup is coming really soon. Kenny's running in, but he only has a FAMAS, and that might not just be enough here. Existence gets a great kill and doesn't get the double, but Kenny picks up one more. This round, I was going to say it's not quite lost yet. The bomb hasn't been planted, so Titan actually have time to work for another pickoff.
I think Adrenaline is going to be the key, the linchpin here for HellRaisers if he remains around mid, but okay. Seems like he's rotating over towards Zaps, which I guess is the safe choice given his HP, but I think Titan has to give up on this.
Yeah, I mean,
too many smokes for HellRaisers in the afterplant for Titan to really safely commit to something.
It looked to me like they were trying to go for a pickoff over at the graveyard where Angel is holding right now. And I think if they had got that pickoff and made it 2-on-2, then they would have really tried to go all in on it. And I think that's actually the most reasonable thing they could have done, right? If you just charge in at 2-on-3, you're not going to be able to do it. But if you can equalize, then you know it's a slight chance. So Titan doing what they do really well, actually.
Yeah, I mean, they realize when enough is enough or it's too late to actually do anything about it. So, yeah. A lot. Actually, you see way too many teams just hope, or maybe I guess too wishful, and they stick around in those situations like that. And when they finally decide to save, they've got T's on their heels, just hunting them down, and they're not able to save at all.
Yeah, and if Titan had thrown away those two rifles, they would have had, you know, what, a FAMAS and a shotgun this round. Instead, they actually have almost all bought up, so they can still come out of this with a 9-6 victory. Like Semler said, that might just be enough here. But we'll see.
Look at NBK. He's got a pretty good gun for the sort of situation that's developing here. HellRaisers, they're really pushing three. They've got three guys. They had four for a second into AAPS, but they're all going balcony with the bomb. Three of them there. NBK's about to get a one hell of a welcoming party. He's got to catch them, and there's the first one, the headshot. NBK only gets one, though.
Oh, that could have been so good, but he did just miss a couple of shots. The first one was a great headshot, but now the bomb site's lost. The bomb is going to be planted, and HellRaisers' positions are so strong right here. This is going to be almost impossible, and the rotation is also very late from the guys in the B bomb site. Again, I think this is a result of the early round when HellRaisers pushed so late in the round that now Titan have sort of been conditioned to wait until the very last second with actually doing anything, and it's binding them right now.
Kill coming in. Smith gets caught, but then Scream returns on Adrian, so that's going to clear things up. We're now into a 3-on-2 situation. They're running out of time, though. They have two kits to work with here, but a good kill on the Kutcher, and there's Doja. They know where he is now. Existence and Scream working together, get
nice.
The kill. And does Scream have the time? Yes, he does. Doja not in a position to stop the defuse.
So, a little bit of confusing play from HellRaisers here. I'm pretty sure they had not just an advantage, but a pretty big advantage in that defense. Roleplay Titan retaking it, and at the end of the half, it's Existence and MBK. Just, you know, to point a little bit of a finger at the people who keep criticizing Existence. Here he is with 14-2-9, doing a fine job. But on the other team, it's Dozier again, top fragging 16 kills in total. That is the first half of this game. If you are just joining us, then welcome to the channel. You are at Room on Fire, and we're watching the SLTV Starseries Season 10 game between Titan and HellRaisers, and there are two great games coming out after this one, so you don't want to go anywhere. But if you want to help us, you can click that follow button on your Twitch page, and we'll definitely appreciate it. And yeah, tell your friends and everything else. There's going to be a lot coming up, including tomorrow on this channel, where we have three best of three games in the Case King of the Hill tournament, which is going to be absolutely brilliant. So don't miss that. If you miss anything else, it's cool, but don't miss tomorrow. All right, second half, guys. HellRaisers, what are they going to do here in the pistol round? Any bids?
Hoping for something fairly safe. I'm not really sure. It's going to be really hard to tell. You see HellRaisers is posting up with a fairly vanilla setup here, and I'm perfectly okay with that, especially since they've got a bit of a... Well, actually, Adren is moving surprisingly aggressive down banana. And yeah, it looks like they're actually... Oh, he's going to... He might get caught here if Titan decides to turn around.
Yeah, this is scary, and they do... he's got to stay alive. If he goes down, that's probably it. He's running back, and he realizes everyone's coming. Backup is going to be there really soon. Angel does have a flashbang, but that might not be enough. And Titan, on the other hand, they turn on the brakes. This is really what calling is all about. This is where you need a strong in-game leader who can tell the troops to fall back exactly at the right time, and maybe Titan have found that time.
Whoa, Angel almost gets caught there, though. One to the face, and he's down to 8 HP. NBK? I mean, look at that, Anders. They use the Molly to check the corner.
Makes me right happy. Does Kucha here taking a lot of damage as well. This is a great start for Titan, but now it's going to come down to some kills. Otherwise, it won't really matter. Kucha's going to actually be the one to pick up one. Dosha with another one. No, Titan was looking so good. But now they're actually inside the bomb site, and it's a 3-on-3, so they have the advantage.
They do, and Scream is swapped out for the USPS. Scream has got it. The first headshot goes in, but that's all he's going to get. Kucha catches him out. Now it is a 2-on-2 situation, but Angel and Kucha are both so very low. It shouldn't happen, but Angel somehow manages it. Existence is out, and now it's all down to Smith on the site.
Are you joking?
Angel does it single-handedly with 8 HP and a CZ in hand. Angel is able to get in there and get the kills.
You must be kidding me. I was... If I had been talking, then I would have said I still think Smith has a very high chance of just doing this 1-on-2. How on earth did they win that 2-on-2 at the end?
I think that's straight up down to the CZ. I think it's just that good. Obviously, the guy wielding it has to know what he's doing, and Angel obviously does, but I don't think he gets that round if he doesn't have a CZ.
Okay, now they're in a bit of a tight spot, Titan, because that's actually both the pistol rounds lost. Even as you said, you know, they did win the second round on the other half, but they still got to be careful here, and they are going to rush up. They did buy an AK, and that has done absolutely nothing so far. They're just trying to pick it up one at a time here. Actually, that's a Galil on Kenny. Does pick up one kill, and they are going to be getting some damage in here. Kucha taking down a teammate, but I'm still not sure if Scream can really win this round.
If you can get down the bomb, this is more than enough for Titan. It's going to be well worth the investment.
Yeah, this is it. He's got a plant. Can he get another kill? No, Markolov, he's not having any of that. He gets in there. He's got plenty of time for the defuse. But that's actually Angel. He wanted to give Titan a helping hand, right? You know, he's like, okay, guys, I know we're that last round, you know, it's been rough for you here. Let me go ahead and give you a freebie.
let me run into Kucha's sights.
Yeah. That's Kucher being a, you know, it's a good guy Kucher, right? He's looking out.
And they're going to buy again. Titan, I love this aggression. This is actually something we wouldn't have seen Titan do, I think, 2 months ago. They would have been saving until they had the money, because they've been a very regimented team like that. But this kind of switch up is kind of interesting, and maybe it'll catch HellRaisers here. They are pushing up aggressively. Angel gets the first one, Kenny with a straight return, and now it's going to be down to Kucha, and he has to fall back and buy time for his team here. He did get the kill with the grenade, but this is still, I mean, 3-on-3 is going to be in the terrorist's favor almost all the time.
Yeah, we just have to see Titan make the right call. But then Kenny's taking a lot of damage here, which is not that great for Titan, because he has so many nades. So they really have to play it patient and let Kenny actually put those to use.
Yeah, I think a lot of it, this is going to come down to what Smith is able to do, whether he's able to draw attention from towards the A-bomb site, or if he's able to maybe get a pick. Because if Markolov rotates over towards B and he picks up Doja, then boom. That's the A side open. But if he's just able to hold Markolov and Doja in place on the A bomb side, that should be enough for Titan to...
They're going to rotate back. Flash is enough to draw Markolov over. You're right. So now Doja is alone here. And Kucha and Markolov right now are very far away. Everything riding on the shoulders of the top fragger. He's going to peek out. He does great damage. And Doja with a double wants one more and very nearly got that kill as well. But I think he's done just enough at this point.
And yeah. I think that's a big mistake from Titan. I have no idea why they would do such a fake and then try to wrap around from Arch. That makes no sense to me. Because obviously, if you're doing a fake like that towards the B bomb site, your hopes is that you're either going to hold off... Well, you definitely want to hold off the people who are holding B already, and you want to try to force a rotation, right? Which they did. They managed to get Markolov out of library towards the B bomb site. But why would
and
you actively...
out of pit.
Yeah, and why would you actively go towards the nearest spot where Markolov can act like the rotations are going to come in from? Why would you ever do that?
That is not a question that we can answer right now, but obviously they thought they had the right plan in mind, and it turned out to be definitely not the right one. And Doja also just had the perfect timing to get that peek over an archway. Now they are back to pistols without any kind of armor or anything. Doja does actually take a fair bit of damage from that initial shot, but this should still be... the first time HellRaisers actually pick up the round lead, if you discount the first round of the first game at least.
What I'm wondering is this another, not stylistic, but tendency of HellRaisers? You know how they don't rotate, right? This is something we've talked about in the past, how they hate rotating that last man off. Do you think that they assume that Doja would be in pit?
Well, even if he is in pit, he's the sole guy on that site. By going around Arch, you're still going to have to deal with the guy in pit, and he's going to have like a field day trying to shoot you down from pit, even if you're coming around Arch.
Hmm.
And still, you're leaving yourself, or you're putting yourself in a position where you're closer to the most likely rotation path from HellRaisers. So you're putting yourself in more danger than what you necessarily need to be. I would much rather see them have Smith still be up in apps, and have him push from out towards balcony while you have two people running around towards quad.
A pretty good denial of Banana here. Just Smoke and Molotov to try and clear out anyone from Titan who might be down here. So good job from HellRaisers, but let's see if the Titan squad can pick it up. And with that kind of opening from Kenny, there's a pretty good chance that they might be able to do it. Markolov holding on quad, and Doja is going to be at archway again. Let's see if he could do what he did last round. He's got one. No, he's actually out of flashbang, so that's a big problem. Angel has rotated in, so now we're going to see an engagement from him. He's going to spot the first people. He makes a lot of noise, and they will know he's there. Markolov with a grenade out, and HellRaisers caught completely off guard in this round. That was actually just a lot of mistakes from HellRaisers there.
And it all started with that Molly. That Molly to the corner of the new corner in Arch.
Yeah, but I think it started maybe even earlier than that. I think Angel could have just let them walk by, and he would have been in library just waiting. But when he doesn't do that, he still sees everyone, which means he should be able to make the call to Markolov that, hey, they're coming around the corner. But Markolov still thought, all right, I'll throw a Molotov on them. That really doesn't make any sense. You know, if you throw a Molotov on someone, it's not like they're going to either stand still or fall back. They will just rush forward and catch you with your, you know, weapon only halfway drawn. So I think some big communication errors on HellRaisers that time, but a great opening from Titan. You know, that initial headshot was fantastic.
Yeah, and I actually think that it was kind of a nifty move coming out from the HellRaisers player in Arch, because when you throw that Molotov, you obviously expect someone to pop out from the noob corner, right? If you're Kenny S. Unfortunately for the HellRaisers players, Kenny S just is so good that he's able to flick him the second he peeks out from Arch, and that kind of set everything into motion for Titan. But it was really well executed from Titan. That was fast and precise.
That to me, yeah, exactly. That, like, contrary to Six, that just looked like very clean work right there. Like Titan, that, you know, Kenny gets the opening, right? But then Kenny and Scream both going towards that A site. They each get the shot that they need. They stop the rotation coming in from library. Like, it all seemed like things kind of came together that round.
I wouldn't say so much they stopped the rotation as Angel just, you know, said, hey, I'm in here, which is, you know, just
so you're expecting that rotation. That's what the one thing I'm wincing, right, when I'm watching the minimap is, are they going to be checking library to make sure that, you know, they don't just go running past the library? And sure enough, you know, They do actually take the time to pause and punish, and you can be sure that they hurt him, but still, you know, they get rid of him. That's the key thing. They can't worry about him getting flanked, or they can't worry about getting flanked that whole time.
Adrian could have had definitely a double kill here. He might have let down the team a little bit. He is going to go down, and it's back into a 2-on-2. Again, HellRaisers coming out much worse in this engagement than they could have. Running through smoke like that, Titan should have definitely been punished. Not that I want to take anything away from Titan, but HellRaisers are making some very silly mistakes right now. The bomb is down, and it's a 2-on-2. Let's see if Smith and MBK can hold on to this.
They've got very good positions right now. At least one in yellow who's going to be looking towards CT. You imagine Markloff with that AWP. He's got to check all of these spots. He's looking towards new boxes and now has to be worried about that back corner. But he needs to look towards the new boxes because that's where Smith is holding up. Doja jumps on the opportunity, though, manages to pick off NBK and turns it into the 1v1. But Smith is still alive with full HP.
Yeah, and Doja is just waiting for the exit kill. Nothing he can do anymore. And he realizes it as well. So Smith's going to explode with the bomb. And Doja, well, just there to watch it. That's Titan retaking it 11-10. But I would count this. I mean, I don't think the last round we were talking about with Library, I'm not sure if even if Angel had waited, that doesn't guarantee that HellRaisers would have won the round. This time, I think they had it way in the bag. That guy holding right here behind the smoke with the M4A1, that should have been an easy victory for HellRaisers. They kind of screwed that up horribly.
Yeah, that is the only way to put it.
Yeah, that wasn't down to like Titan doing anything special. They were so flashed when they came through, but
yeah, they did one of the cardinal sins in CSGO, which is to run through smoke. And normally you would get punished by doing so, but HellRaisers weren't able, or they weren't up to the task.
And that's a problem because now they have pistols and the one M4 that they saved from the last round here. 11-10 and Titan moving closer to a victory at this point.
But I like this. I like what HellRaisers are doing. This is something we actually don't see that often. We saw this a lot more in both 1.6 and Source, and that's leaving the one guy with the weapon on a site alone. Which obviously could, you know, you could argue that, well, you want to protect the guy with the weapon, so we potentially could pick up more kills. But I also like the idea of not babysitting him completely, because you're going to leave one bomb site completely bare, and they don't have weapons to protect themselves.
Yeah, smokes are going to rain in. Are they going to actually commit to this push? It sort of feels like they are. They've brought the bomb over here as well. And the flashes of the first smokes are already in. Still 30 seconds. If they push through right now, there's not going to be a smoke. And Angel and Doja, one M4 and one C-set, it can be enough.
Yeah, though, this is certainly more than enough to do it. But Doja gets picked off immediately. Do they check the angle? Yes, they do. Angel still gets one, but that's good enough for Titan. They have the time now. 15 seconds. They will get this plant. Checking all the angles, but nobody's home. B site is theirs. HellRaisers now are going to be rotating around, but they only had CZ75s to do something about it.
Yeah, so the name of the game here is exit frags. Try and make sure that Titan's economy stays as low as possible so that once they can buy in the next round, they'll be able to do something. But a good execute from Titan, making sure they get in there, get the bomb down, and don't really worry about anything. And MBK with two stunning kills, especially the first one on Doja, was really cool.
Yeah, that was just a superb entry frag.
Yeah. That's very important, because that's what loses you the round, right? You lose your first guy like that, and then you try and make up for it, and there's a guy with a CZ 75 in the corner, and things get much worse. Yeah. No kills either for Markloff, and maybe Adrian's going to come in here, but actually Titan are going to wait here, not push all the way down, which is a good idea. Don't want to throw away any rifles, and they won't, so solid play. NBK with 3 kills and top fragging on his team with 19, still Doja a little bit higher up with 21, and we're at 12-10 going into the 23rd round.
Right, well, here's the big round, right, boys? This is it. HellRaisers, they absolutely need to win this round. Just lock it down solid, because they have the richest member on their team is $150 on Angel. So this is definitely a big round for HellRaisers. If they lose this, they're going to be back to pistols. And then Titan, they're knocking at this game's door. They're so close to taking it. So they Titan are really taking their time, getting up top to quad. And HellRaisers holding very passively, so this is interesting to note. They're not really peeking forward to get that information. They're really holding back, making sure the Titan have to come to them.
And what can we really expect here? That's the thing. I mean, I think the entry frag has been the all deciding factor at this point. Whoever gets that is very likely to actually just win the round. Angel's walking over here. Kenny's looking right at the edge, and Kenny will get the opening frag. So nicely done, just using that smoke to his advantage. Now they are going to go back and pick up the bomb and maybe actually going to rotate over towards the B bomb side. If they do and they leave Scream up here, it could be very effective.
Scream gets picked off.
Yeah, that's not good. Those are point blank on him. We have the rotation already coming through from Kucher as well. But now the question is, I mean, Titans still have time to change their mind as well. They could back off. But it seems like they're going to go flash. They're going to run through that smoke. And now it's going to come down to Adrian, who gets the first one. The second one as well. Adrian with a great headshot. He's done his job. He's slowed them down enough. Now Titan are stuck in their tracks, and they're about to get sandwiched.
He actually got a third headshot as well, Adrian. So that is some pretty good defending coming out here from the Kazakhstanian player on the team. Existence is the only one left here in a 1-on-4. And remind us again, or just to remind everyone again, HellRaisers are boot camping everyone except Markloff here. So Adrian is down to, you know, just 20 ping instead of 120. That's obviously a big difference, but that was a pretty critical defense. And now Existence is, they're going to find him, and they will. Are they able to kill him? That's the big thing. Eventually, that took a long time to get that kill in. 12-11 here, and now Titan, they can actually buy up.
They've got enough. Existence will probably just... Oh, well, then again, Smith could drop a gun for Existence. Yeah. But then again, I wouldn't be surprised to see Existence just go P250 armor with nades, and he will do just that. So, AKs, and the one pistol, the brave pistol on the in-game leader for Titan. But that was a round that at all costs Titan had to win. But three members live for HellRaisers, meaning they have the money to get fully equipped here.
Oh, flashes rain out. Adrian peeks and actually almost overextends his position, but they do fall back, and that's something that I think that's a change up for HellRaisers as well, where I think previously they might have just kept, you know, fighting over on Banana, even if they were getting gunned down quite a bit. So I'm kind of excited to see them falling back. Again, these are some pretty small details, but in the grand scheme of things, it does make a difference. And that's the entry frag in favor of HellRaisers.
This is almost the round in favor of HellRaisers at this point. I mean, there's still a minute, and Titan can still do quite a bit. They've got three smokes, a nade, and a flash, so they've got some tools here to work with. But they need to find the right kills here, because right now they're a man down going into this site, and HellRaisers, they've rotated another man over to A. They're going to be with just a 2 on B, 3 on A setup here.
Kucha, oh, that could be really dangerous, just running out of library just when Kenny's about to peek, but obviously he doesn't know that now. He is going to know, because they've just smoked it off, and they're going to be running through the CT spawn over towards the B bomb site. If they pick off MBK, that's not going to be quite as effective. Kucha will take down the bomb, and there's only 25 seconds left. Things are not looking good here for the French team. Existence is going to run in, and it's a 1-on-5. In spite of all the damage they've done this round, Titan, to multiple players, it's just not enough to actually net them a kill yet, and they won't get one either. Markolov also drops down to 57, but he doesn't die. And then the score is equalized, and Titan, I mean, a lot of big things here. They didn't kill a single member on HellRaisers. They did not get the bomb down, and they're going to have to eco. I'm a little bit worried here.
I'm actually surprised that, well, the two last rounds we've seen from Titan have been very awkwardly executed. In the 23rd round, where we saw Titan going towards the B bomb site, they hesitated before they went in, and that was all Adren needed to really get into place and shut down the entire push. And in the very in the last round, right just now, Kenny S actively searched for Kucher in library with the bomb. I honestly don't know why he would do that, because they had no control over the B bomb site at that point, and they had 25 seconds to go. So you obviously have to get an instant pickoff on Kucher, and that's the only option that's acceptable in that situation. And if you don't do it, you've basically lost a round for your team. So I don't really see that. I would much rather see Titan just completely ignore Kucher, run down Speedway, and work with MBK to actually get control over that B bomb site so that they can get the bomb down, buy themselves some more time. If they die while trying to take the B bomb site, well, at least they, you know, gave it a shot. What they did right there was basically throwing away members one by one and not putting Existence in a horrible position to do anything at all.
And now look at what they've been doing this round. I mean, Sam, this is something we've seen a couple of times already from the French team, is taking basically a timeout in the round, just talking it over, and now they're going to go for the B bomb site, but, you know, they've been planning the next round, basically.
Angel, this is sick. Angel, they line up for him. It's not over yet. Now Adrian gets to lend a hand. Is Angel going to get the last one, though? He's going for the knife! Oh, and Scream punishes him for it. The audacity. Scream won't have any of it, Angel. Doesn't matter. He just clipped your wings.
Oh, that is fantastic. Instant karma. Trying to knife Scream. Not going to happen. All right, then. So there's a little bit of fun in this game, too. 13-12. I mean, this seems like a really close battle between these two teams, and that makes me excited, because that makes me think Titan have improved a lot during the last weeks of practice here, which is very good news.
It absolutely is, both for Titan and everyone rooting for Titan, but also for people who like to watch good CS in general, because Titan have been fairly underwhelming as of late, so it's good to see that they're on the right track again.
Bit of a flashbang out. Are they going to flash again? Yeah, there is a pop flash for Angel to peek, but the smoke actually already sort of prevents anyone from being there, so they just fall back and use a couple of grenades to do that with. Adrian still has a smoke, which is important to keep track of, and Kucher actually has one as well. He could help smoke out towards that B bomb site, so I think an A execute right now would be better for Titan, and they seem to think the same.
And look at Kenny. Picked up the AWP for the first time.
Yeah, this is big. Kenny, yes, he's actually got the sniper rifle, and Dozen gets rid of him immediately. Oh, they can't even get an existence. He gets re-peaked by Kucher and punished. He had his knife out. Nothing he could do there. This is falling apart for Titan.
Especially because Markolov is so close. If Scream makes any mistake and looks the wrong way, Markolov's going to charge in on him. Now they're going to rotate back to the B bomb site where, oddly enough, HellRaisers have decided we don't need this bomb site anymore. We're just going to, you know, pull Adrian from it, even though we have five members alive. That seemed like a big over-rotation, but they are getting back into place now, which is pretty important. Not sure what possessed them to try and move out there. Six shot from Adrian will take down one, and NBK in the corner is going to run right into Angel and will actually take him down.
But this is still a 2-on-4 situation. 10 seconds left on this clock. They need to get this bomb plant, but Kucher puts a stop to it. Scream drops the bomb in the middle of nowhere. It's now down to NBK. But HellRaisers don't even have to face at this point. He's not planted the bomb. They run in and check it. Adrian will even get the kill. That's like the cherry on top. And now HellRaisers, 14 rounds. And exactly, Anders. No bomb plant means the Titans, they're at like $3,000. They just don't have any money to put in a big buy here when they need it most.
No. The fact that they had no bomb plant really makes a big difference, because that, I mean, that's a round they have now without any rifles. And this is going to be, if HellRaisers win this, which is, you know, not written anywhere that they will, but if they do, it's match and map point for them, and Titan are fighting at best for a draw.
Titan, I think, have been fighting at best for a draw for a long time here. It's just, it seems like the momentum has petered away, and HellRaisers, they've only gotten stronger. Markolov continues to dominate, drops NBK, Angel now finds existence. And Doja walks right into Kenny S and Apartments. This is done. Titan, they're about to fold here. Doja in the Apartments with the spray on Scream. Despite getting headshot, dropped to 1 HP. He still gets it. And now it's going to be Kucher. 15 rounds now for HellRaisers. One round till they win.
And the money for HellRaisers right now is also kind of ridiculous. It means that even if Titan win two rounds in a row, then HellRaisers can still buy for the 30th round. So we'll see. It's obviously all in this round. And the fact that they picked up three Molotovs could be an indication that they might actually try and go for the B-bomb site.
The Burning Ring of Fire, hopefully.
It could be.
Oh, we've seen a lot of mollies from them throughout this entire T half, and I haven't really seen any kind of B executes out of them using them that way.
Yeah, so they've been using it to smoke off the noob corner, really, for the most part.
Ooh, grenade is too late, so Titan fall back in time. Good news from them. That could have been quite a devastating grenade. We'll see what they're going to do. This time, look at the smoke from Smith. Definitely going to be a smoke towards Archway, and that could be a big tell. But also for HellRaisers, I mean, once you see those Archway smokes, you know what's coming. So one smoke there, and actually one for Library as well. It's a very nice smoke.
Well, let's see. Smith's pre-firing around the corner. Great flash from Kucher. He gets two. Reward is there for him, and now it's two guys holding in the pit for HellRaisers. Markolov gets two as well.
So they smoke off Archway, which means, you know, you can run safely towards Archway. I guess Kucher was there, but the rest who run through quad, then I don't know. That kind of fell apart with Kucher getting that double kill, I guess. That's unfortunate, because it's always nice seeing, you know, when teams have practiced these smokes and are ready to put them down, but that just was not successful. Adrian is going to spot out existence, and we'll take him down, and it's 16-12 victory for HellRaisers.